There is, there are some slides which are actually on screen as well. I'll go as quickly as I can. Okay, Deputy John Fondre, I'm a current politician. I'm about 12 and a half years in the States. Background-wise, I'm past being Assistant Minister of Treasury, Chief Minister's Parliament and TTS. I'm presently President of Scrutiny, Chairman of the Corporate Services Scrutiny Panel. I have sat on a previous hospital review panel along with Chris Taylor, and I'm presently sitting on another hospital review panel, and I'm also the chair of the Brexit review panel. All of the comments I'm about to make are my own, if not attributable to any other body of which I sit on. Privately, I sit on as a trustee on a housing trust, and therefore I have had a marginal experience of some development work. I'm definitely not an expert. I would just say, so in these roles in the past, as some of the officers will know, I was responsible for Desert Property Holdings for about 5 years, and that time was made aware of the need for a new hospital, and at the time actually we were doing scoping for a mental health facility at Overdale. So my position is I do accept the need for a new hospital. When I sat on the first hospital panel, I was basically site neutral. The costs became clear at that point. I'm using their numbers. I do not dispute the ones from Chris Taylor, but the official numbers were the waterfront was £20 million cheaper. That actually becomes £40 million cheaper when you bring in the finance costs if it was 40 years and 2.5% borrowing. I was not able to take part in the debate in November 2016 because of a bereavement, and in fact I was in the hospital in the run-up to the debate looking out over the development site. So the main concerns for me started at the cost of the proposed scheme, the controls of the contingencies, and then the noise and disturbance of patients. We were then involved looking at funding the proposed debt. That's not relevant today either. I probably most recently became seriously alarmed when I saw the images from the photo montages. They were originally included in a planning objection, but also they come from the application, and bluntly, I think it looks like they've dropped a nuclear power station into St Helier. And I accept this is going to be in principle, it's about massing, etc. I understand remarks may be made that the building ultimately will not look like this, that's what was said to the States as a presentation, but bluntly, trying to make this look pretty simplistically will be about as effective as putting makeup on a warthog. So I'm concerned with the cost, and at the various presentations to State members, the point was made that this is a special place. It's where people come to be helped, to be healed, to be born, and also it may be their last destination. So it has to be about people as well. Can I ask one very quick question? Is the height, what is the actual height of the building? I've had different measures from different things I've seen. Is it 47 metres or is it 50 metres?
I think everybody apart from you knows this off by heart. 43 metres for the building and an extra 4 for the chimney.
Thank you. Okay, so 47 metres. I picked up there are rather a lot of issues around them. What I will do is I use as a basis the comments actually from the planning officer, which is John Nicholson, just to run through some of the images behind, which is to an extent what we as States members have actually seen. And this might inform, because obviously that touches on the document that we were just given from the team over there, which obviously is one of the presentations that came through earlier. And what I was very concerned about, whizzing as quickly as I can, obviously, Mr. Nicholson says the future hospital will need to integrate into the existing character and grain of the town. It'll need to demonstrate principal sustainability as well as contributing to the enrichment of the town environment. I understand comments we made that doesn't look like it's going to happen on the basis of the present scheme. What I found very disappointing when I went through the planning officer's thing is the errors that have been found. I gather that's been touched on it. It says concerns remain about some elements of the submission, and rather without explanation, it shows a smaller building. It becomes obvious they are not representative of the scheme under consideration. Bearing in mind, we'll touch through the images behind me as to what the public and state departments have seen, this is reinforcing that I'm concerned about that. I would consider that shocking. A further significant concern is in relation to the accuracy of the heights of the building shown on several drawings, in relation to the presentation of heights, what it keeps going. It very diplomatically talks about causing confusion. Okay, we've established the comment is the change in scale is so great, even when taking account of the inset upper floors, there cannot be anything other than unreasonable harm to the amenities of the residents, in particular reference to overshadowing and overbearing relationships when we talk about Newgate Street. Now, what I would like to do on these frames up here, if we do one, I'll say one to be on the page. The first three, we can do this image very quickly, this is what people saw on one of the presentations, these are from a video. The next slide obviously shows, just go down, what was originally proposed about a year ago that one would have seen from Gloucester Street. Next slide, again all from the same video. Oddly enough, on this slide, this is the only image I could find that gave an indication of the actual height of the building, if that makes sense, from that angle. We go next slide. Whereas later on, sort of a better image, I would say this looked like a roughly five-story building, give or take. And if you just, as you should, if we can go back, scratching up by about an inch, it's roughly comparable in height to the building adjacent to it visually. We go to the next slide, and this is relevant to what we were given, because these images are in these documents. The images, the right hand, well basically, if you look at the granite building, it makes it look like the image, the green arm that's closest to the granite building looks about the same height.
Yep.
That's what we would have seen at some point if I'd seen this image from State Bank.
That's what I was going by, burn face, that's exactly that.
And the next green, from the other angle, again from the Gloucester Street end, from goes on fractionally, it does look like, if you remember that high image I referred to, look like about five stories. It looks like they are similar in heights to the
towers.
Now, what I did want to pick up on, go to the next screen, it's not actually the image, it's the writing at the bottom of it. Because it refers to consultation, this was presented to States members, this is straight out of the presentation to States members, I think it's June 17, consultation undertaken with planning officers and the Jersey Architectural Commission to test planning policy in support of the outline planning application. Now what, actually just to pause there, what I've then found a great concern is the images in Mr. Nicholson's report, which basically gives the quotes from the Architectural Commission. It says that the sheer scale and massive height of this building remain a major challenge for the design team and a major concern for the Commission. The Commission are still to be convinced that a building of this scale can be successfully integrated into this tight urban site. It then says these views are shared by the Department of Environment. It also, and all I'm saying is, what this infers to state members is that the Planning Commission are broadly supportive, or there are ongoing positive discussions happening around the height and mass of the building. If we go to the next slide, obviously what we've seen then, which is obviously somewhat different to the earlier slide we've just seen, this was the last image we saw. I do recall, because I was about a minute late to the presentation, I said, that is awful. And I thought, oh, it won't look like that, because this is just about mass. But this is what we're being asked to, or you're being asked to approve. If we go to the next image, this is also at the back of the presentation, it's also a publicly available image that went to state members. And actually, just as an aside, an architectural acquaintance did point out to me certain little tricks of the trade occasion, making images look presentable. So obviously, in terms of, this is an image that's one of the images that's used to sell to state members and the public. So it's a nice colourful image, it's lovely colours, it's obviously dusk. You've got street lights right next to you, which are the tallest thing in the entire picture. We've got lots of bright lights. And then funny enough, tucked away in the corner is this glowing cube, which looks quite pretty at the end of the day. If we actually go to the go to the next slide briefly, I fail to understand, this obviously does identify 47 metres at the top. I've never quite understood the difference between the two dotted lines, as either is 47 metres or it isn't. But why are we showing something that seems to go take your foundations down twice the height, at the same height as the building is high? Doesn't that just distort the impression of the height in terms of the cut-through? That's just an observation. But anyway, to go page down, then is obviously what's coming out of Arab. This is the before, and we go to the next one, and we go, and that's the after. Compare that to the lit image that we had just previously. If we then go, as we all know, to the next one, that's the before, and we go to the next one, and voila, your nuclear power station. That image has never been seen by state members officially.
Shame.
Wow. I can tell you that, absolutely.
Shame.
Now, what I did want to briefly touch on is an actual planning policy side of things. I note SP 7 talks about scale, height and massing, first local character and design of place, GD 5, proposed development that has a seriously detrimental impact by virtue of its siting scale, profile or design, asserting landmark and listed buildings place will not be permitted. This then seems to tie into the likes of the issues around the Opera House and Kensington Place and the character stuff. GD7, scale, form, mass orientation, siting and density development in without reviews. That's under, I think, better but by design. We've covered that. I'm trying to pick on HD1, which is picked on by Tracy Ingram and her submission. Proposals which do not preserve or enhance the special particular interest of the listed building or place and their settings will not be approved. Now, the thing that really I picked on those, sir, is I wanted to get to BE5. I have an interest in BE5 because I was actually one of the people who amended it in the debates some time ago, and that probably lost me any friends I had in the architectural world. But the point was, it used to refer to stories. I can't remember the setting, and the issue came down to what is a story? Because if it's residential, it's a certain height. If it's commercial, it would be double the height. So actually, the amendment I brought was to convert it into metres. I'm not against tall buildings. That was actually my thing. This is about enabling tall buildings. However, policy then goes on, and it says, if we're only permitted where their exceptional height can be fully justified, development proposals for tall buildings which fail to justify their exceptional height relative to the following criteria will not be permitted. And they talk about a variety of things that includes visual impact, hence the image on the screen, impact on views, and contribution and character to superior. I would submit that all of those are breached by this application, and I would hope, therefore, that although it is a hospital and it is needed, the actual sheer impact on this, if we don't get it right, must mean we've got to follow normal planning procedures. If we get it wrong, my children will be in their 70s before it can be sorted out. This is a 60-year building. And I really reiterate the planning officer's comments. The size of the site, the nature of the brief, has resulted in the building, which is considered to be overscaled, out of character with the immediate area and wider townscape, including heritage assets. As we've heard, the Opera House is quite unique in the islands, in the UK, actually, and which unreasonably harms the amenities of residents in the area. The scheme that the photos of the political and would concern that those that just come from part of the applicant's things show the before and after in, I think it's Newgate Street, as towards Kensington Place, and the before shows, yes, there's buildings across the road. The after, I thought my computer had gone wrong, was a beige image, and it's because literally that's all the applicant will see because it's the concrete wall in front of them. And it says the departments of the view that the outline application falls short of the requirements of the island plan. Given the indicative nature of the majority of the submission, the contents of the full approval information is considered inadequate to bridge the gap. Now, I've covered an awful lot on my thing, and what I did also want to add, you have the pictures which I'd like to just refer to.
15 of the 10
minutes. Okay, sorry, I will be as quick as I can. What I want to talk about on massing. I accept, I've always understood, it's not about what the alternative sites were. When the debate was going on, as I said, I couldn't take place in November because of bereavement, but I did assist in certain areas, and we did use the planning 3D model. And what we produced was what would it look like down next to the Radisson for the square meterage that we're looking at, and we could play around with. And that just gave an illustration that in terms of what was feasible here, on a very simplistic basis, as a non-narrative that was put together by the planning officers today, who were very helpful, versus was not overpowering, in my view, compared to what we are getting now. What I really want to also just touch on, and I will be starting to wrap up, but I'd like to know the majority of it, is noise. And what happened is, as a parish representative, I received this, which hopefully. Now, I don't know if that's loud enough. It was taken from a ward, and it carries on, and apparently it carried on all day. I'll actually turn off. And for me, I understand from a colleague that he took a sound machine into the corridor of that the following day, and it reached 84 decibels. Now, I'm not too sure there if that works because of distance and things like that, but certainly when I played, and this is a very small machine, when I played on my computer at home, and it's as received, I was horrified. Because I do not see whatever noise mitigation measures we are going to get, how one deals with it. As I said, I was in a room where a relative family was dying, and I was looking over from the wards to the building site directly. I think the noise will be magnified, for example, by the granite building, and you can have as many noise mitigation measures as one likes. This was I presume it's a Kangoo on the edge of a bulldozer, and it was work that was being done, I believe, earlier this year. And it was, I would say that was unacceptable from the point of view. This went on for days, as I understand it. I touched on briefly, I'd like to know, I've got five paragraphs left. Westway Court. Westway Court is on the critical path of the whole scheme. I'm not even sure where we are at present, where it is behind schedule. My understanding that design was meant to be finished on the 9th of June this year, and construction was actually meant to be starting on the 4th of September this year on the one programmes that was published. And yet, they've actually, certainly in the presentation that was given to state members, which is that one's not on the best title, goodness, that includes a reference, there's a cross-section of the building, and that particularly says theatres, critical care and pathology. And I understand very, very recently that pathology has moved across, so I'll just reiterate the points. This seems to be a moving feast. Things still seem to be moving on, and it all seems very, very pressurised. That means mistakes get made. I again pay tribute to the health and JPH teams who are having to work under this pressure. I think they've done a lot of good work, but I'm looking at it from a longer thing. I also talk about, and Westway Court is critical in all this. I understand they're putting a pneumatic tube between the main hospital and the path that now to go across. I was talking to a relatively elderly resident, a member of the family, who was describing her experiences of dropping older relatives, her mother and her late husband, well, late mother as well, at Quinnefugan, and having to then put the car into Patrick Street, which is like a minute away. This is now going to be significantly further away, and I would suggest that the patient's experience of that is going to be difficult. I think we're just about there. What I was going to say is I've understood that we're looking at about 200,000 trips to the hospital each year. I'm sure that can be corrected if it's wrong, but it's that kind of number. And I don't know the difference between what will go to the main hospital and what will go to the Westway Court site, but it would seem to me there will be some reasonable traffic generation there. I'm not going to go to there too much. Compulsive purchase is an issue to me. It is a risk. It will have to go to the States if it gets to that stage. I would not be supporting it, I have to say, because I don't think I can justify forcing somebody to sell a house to the States on a scheme that's more expensive. It's going to cause a lot of disturbance to fragile patients and having such an overbearing impact to St Helier. So really, to conclude, in my view, it's our duty to ensure the States' money is being well spent. It needs to be a scheme we can be proud of, and it has to be affordable. If we end up with something that's an eyesore, something that costs more than it should do, and I'm looking at the alternatives that were produced, I think we failed on the counts. As I said, I think it's something like 200,000 trips each year. I remain very concerned about the noise and disturbance to patients during the construction time, because that would be for those who are dying and for those who are being born. And do we really want their first or last noises that they hear to be the sound of basically an 84 decibel Kangoo hammer? I think it will overpower everything. I think it will dominate St Helier, and it looks like a nuclear power station being dropped into town, and that cannot be right. For all of the planning reasons I've emphasised, and perhaps more importantly, that the planning officers and the Architectural Commission have identified. And that's it.